How do you set width or height of an element to 100% if there's a margin involved? I bet you're using the calc function to subtract that margin value from 100%. There is a much simpler way to handle this. Here's how. In this demo, I have a container with width and height set to 250 pixels. I'm using logical properties here, inline size and block size, and padding for that container is set to 20 pixels. The child element here has a fixed size, 150 pixels. If you're wondering about the shapes, I'm using corner shape CSS property to create this beautiful shape here. If you want to learn how it works, check out the link in the description and on the screen. So I want this box to be 100% width and height of the parent container. I will set block size to 100% and inline size to 100%. Right now the container is off exactly for the size of the border, which is 10 pixels. So we can easily fix that. You already know how by using box sizing border box. Let's set it. Now this will be sized perfectly. But what happens if I add a margin here? Let's set it to 30 pixels. And now it clearly goes off. We can handle this by subtracting the margin value from the block size. We can do this using the calc function. And the value is going to be 100% minus 2 times 30 pixels. And inline size has to be exactly that as well. Now we do have exactly what we want. We're subtracting the margin from our height and width, but this is not a flexible or an elegant solution because if we were to change this margin here, then our values would be off again. The better way to handle this is to use stretch in CSS. The stretch value is similar to 100%, but it takes margin into consideration. So I'm going to set block size and inline size to stretch. Now this works exactly as expected, and I'm going to comment out the calc lines just so you can see for yourself that this really does work. Unfortunately, the stretch value is still not in the baseline. It's only supported in the Chrome at the moment, but there are alternative values you can use for Firefox and Safari. For Safari, you can use WebKit fill available value, and it works exactly the same as the stretch value. And for Firefox, you can use Moz available value, which again works exactly as stretch. Those are not standard, so you will want to use support's add rule to make sure that you don't mess something up once Firefox and Safari start supporting the stretch value. Unfortunately, there is another downside to this, and in Firefox and Safari, those alternative values work only with width or inline size properties. So this won't work with the block size or with height, unfortunately, in Safari and Firefox. Still, in my experience, the most common use case is with the width property, so you will be able to use stretch to fill in that need and to avoid using calc function to subtract margins when you're dealing with full width containers. Would you like to see the stretch keyword in the browser soon? Let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in a different stretch keyword. Or rather, in the next video.